Hello, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. This is Dr.Bhawani Sankaradhikari. Today he has brought new concept of writing paragraph. And it is in BBS first year in business English. And the topic is coherent paragraphs. How we write coherent paragraphs? What is coherent paragraph writing? This is the idea. And what sort of idea is called coherent paragraph writing? Let's see. A paragraph is a group of sentences and it must be organized in a logical form with the idea of topic sentence and the theme. Topic sentence means thesis statement, main idea of the writing. It is the process of unification of writing in a logical and connected way of the ideas. It is an arranging of words, phrases, and sentences to provide the main idea of the message and to help the readers understand the facts and details with examples. It must be highly formal and documented with grammatically well-structured patterns. The three basic elements are there for coherent paragraph writing. First, topic sentence should be there. Second, supporting sentences should be there to develop the topic and the topic in the details. And third one is transitional words and phrases. Transitional words and phrases, these are the three: topic sentence and then supporting sentences and transitional words and phrases are to be given focus in the coherent paragraph writing, right? Topic sentence focuses on the entire writing, either it is one paragraph or many paragraphs. It gives the summary of the general idea discussed in the rest of the paragraph. Topic sentence is also called thesis statement, and it comes generally in the introductory paragraph. The topic sentence introduces the subject matter of writing. It is a guideline of whole writing process, what follows in the rest of the paragraphs. For example, while writing an essay about the television, we can make the topic sentence like this. This article has focused on merits, demerits, and the use of television in day-to-day life of the global citizens, and its concluding ideas, including recommendations as well as opinions of the authors regarding the television, that is TV. This is one example, unior example. This is topic sentence, and it talks, and now this topic sentence says everything what we are going to write, how many paragraphs we are going to make. And according to this topic sentence, one paragraph is introduction, and within introduction, this topic sentence is there. And we write one paragraph only merits, and another paragraph we write only demerits, and another paragraph we write about the day-to-day use of television in global citizens, and another paragraph concluding ideas, we write conclusion there, and we write give even recommendation means advice. And writer's opinions in another paragraph. This is how the whole writing is within this topic sentence, within this thesis statement. We cannot go beyond this topic sentence. We cannot go out of this topic sentence, whatever we have said. We cannot write other unrelated, irrelevant ideas beyond this topic sentence. So it is called topic sentence. And if we go out through this topic sentence, if we bring more supporting points to this topic sentence, other points to support about demerits of television in one paragraph and merits of television in another paragraph. In merits of television, we can talk about education system, children getting education, we get total information throughout the world. These are some of the merits. And demerits, people watch television, they do not study, they do not give focus in the book, and maybe less reading is there, more watching television is there, and other things we talk about demerits. And in television use day-to-day life in global citizens, old people also just you watch television and make a television as their best friends in their life. They do not need any helpers and supporters. And even recommendation, television channels should be made according to the need. For children, there should be okay education system. For adult, there should be okay funny types of activities. And for film watcher, for game, okay, PUBG. So many things we can use there. So not all the out of these topic sentences we can go. So this is how the language, the writing becomes coherent. Writing become is guided with the topic sentence throughout the writing. But there must be transition too. Then the supporting statements and sentences must be used only related with the pros and cons, means benefits, merits and demerits of TV in the rest of the paragraphs. The irrelevant ideas and sentences must not mixed, must not be, yeah, be chute cha, must not be is there, be is mixed, missed, please, right there, must not be mixed. Without just be, it cannot be past participle, must not be mixed in the writing. Yeah, be lekhnu parcha, must not be mixed in the writing. And coherence should be words to words, phrases to phrases, and sentences to sentences, and paragraphs to paragraphs. There should be co-relationship, coherent, logical, okay, connected ideas should come there in coherent paragraph. Writing must connect from the beginning to the end, and it needs to be linked tightly both in ideas and in paragraphs perfectly. Right, each paragraph contains again another topic sentence, and that paragraph describes about the particular topic sentence of the particular paragraph only. And each different paragraphs do have different topic sentences, and they are also connected to one another. Right, in this case, transitions, but, yet, whereas, however, moreover, further, besides, apart from, in addition, nevertheless, in brief, in short, in conclusion, to sum up, meanwhile, in fact, on the contrary, likewise, similarly, there are many words, transitional words, we must use these, this must be used, these transitional words. These transitions are the indicators of what changes are about to take place in the paragraph. Transitions help to know what changes is going to take place, what changes are going to take place in the paragraphs. The transitions connect the one ideas to another and give the logical and smooth flow of the content of the writing. Because of transitions, smooth flow, logical flow of the ideas and sentences and the contents go ahead, and they help to avoid the confusion for the readers. When the transitions are used, and then they avoid for the bewilderment, for the confusion, for complication of the readers, right, to understand the ideas. Writing any paragraph needs the transitions. And in absence of them, writing does not become coherent and clear to understand for the readers. This is one idea how we write coherent writing. And coherent writing means making connection from the beginning to the end. From the beginning, topic sentence is there, thesis statement is there, and topic sentence and thesis statements are almost connected with the supporting statements, supporting sentences, and we can bring examples, we can bring details, but only related to the ideas or the topic sentence, and we can conclude that ideas, but there must be transitions used furthermore, and thus, and there are different types of names are also given to the transitions, but I have brought those transitions without giving the names. So this is how we can bring a kind of logical paragraph that is coherent paragraph, and coherent paragraph is called always logical paragraph. Okay, thank you. You can read it and enjoy it.